you about Flutter. And what I'm trying to do is give you a basic introduction about the UI and what you can do with Flutter, and then perhaps leave you with some suggestions to do, and then have resources you can actually check out. So if you haven't set up, you can go to Flutter.io. I don't think the network is really good right now, and maybe in your home you could try it. So call the Flutter there. And then there is the SDK, and there's the setup is all there. You could try it out. For those of you who downloaded it and want to actually do things with me as I go, you're very welcome. So I'll try to introduce you what it is. Flutter introduced Saragatra. At the time when I was starting, it was only for mobile apps, being iOS. But now Flutter is expanding the technology to almost all UI. So if you want a web, and there's coming out, and also a desktop. For even a desktop that you can build from Flutter, the same purpose. So the desktop would be on the common OSs and also on Chrome OS. So you can check them out. If you have seen them in Flutter 1.0, it's really great. So I shouldn't say no more of this, and we should dive right through. So we only have an hour. So what I was trying to do is, 14 minutes would be me introducing you here and trying to call it what is basically a chat app, a simple chat app. I wanted to connect it to Firebase, but the network is really basically how you can build a simple app, you can add animation, and how you can add functionalities in the future. That's all it was going to be. So it will probably take 14 minutes, and I'll help you out if you have any problems if you're following along in the next 20 minutes. So I do wish you goodbye. So let's start from scratch. Let's remove everything. So after you created a new project, you have this setup. When there's Android, iOS, where your APKs are stored, and there's the link where you actually code your app. Inside the link, there is the root file called main.start, so every program starts from here. So what you want to do is any program, I'll try to show you the hello that you would be doing in the app. So the first thing would be define our name. The main method is supposed to run an app. There's a method called, I haven't imported blockers. Okay, so in here would be the root widget. So everything is widgets once you design. So I don't know if there is a similar case in React Native, and it's really similar to that. So what you do is, you have your root widget right here to be called. So let's create a new widget. It's going to be an object of a stateless widget. You can use the shortest stateless, and then you can wait automatically. So let's call it chat. So inside this chat app, what is all this? I'll tell you in detail about what are stateless and stateful widgets. What you really need to know right now is it's supposed to render some kind of UI, and that UI would be declared inside this view method. So currently it just returns a container. Let's make it a material app. Making it a material app would offer us access to a variety of contents you can see on Android apps, like app bars, bottom navigation bars, body, and all stuff. So you can start this up, hold the Java, the factor micro, and then it wouldn't do nothing because there is no UI component right now, but I'll just print out some text, and ugly text will be really the red, and it will be not much useful, but so let's try it. In the meantime, One of the features I wanted to show you about Flutter, and I hope you would love, is the hot reload and the, actually the hot reload and the hot restart. So previously, if you have done Android projects, it would be like, if you want to restart, there is an install run, but it would literally build a new APK and try to install it. But in Flutter, you could actually save the state of your app. So if you had, I don't know, tried out something, but you want to change in the middle of something, you could just control save, and it will be, it would reflect the change. So you can see this hello world is really ugly right now because we haven't put any kind of status on it. So what I recommend to do is, you can add a new stateless object. Inside this, we have a scaffold. What a scaffold really does is, just like the actual scaffold, if you're in civil engineering somehow, you might heard the word scaffold as in the framework to build stuff, I guess. I think that's why. So scaffold gives you access to a bunch of things like app bar. You can declare an app bar here. You can make it, give it a title of a text. And then you could move this text into the body of. So you have an up bar on the top, you have a body, and then you can have a bottom. It gives you easy access, and then you don't have to do everything by yourself. So just remove this, try this. Okay, now it's kind of good. You can wrap it in a center with it. There's a big thing. And I'm just going to do it's alt-enter, I've set it up alt-enter here too, so there's a quick widget library you can add, so you can add adding some more widgets, columns, I'll tell you about this. So basically there's a hello world. As you can see, it's really fast. I can change like this, and then it will reflect instantly. That's what I was thinking about the hot reload. So now, let's actually see the code that we are trying to build. It's in Google Code Lab. You can check it. Google Code Lab and Flutter search. It's the one that says building beautiful UIs. It's supposed to be a chat app, but it doesn't really have a functionality for a reason. So we just look at the UIs and how we can build this. Okay. Now you can set up your requirements, like your projects, and then building the interface. It's simply going to be a chat, and then after you enter the messages that we just put with some kind of animation. So we're trying to build this. So what we would do is break it down to components. You would try it. So you can go and check it out and follow along if you have a PC already set up. So the first thing would be to comment. Okay, the text input. So that text input you saw, we'll try to build that first. Let's have a function to build text field, I guess. You know what this does is it returns something. That something would be a text field. Simply a text field. And then let's see what actually happens. So you just have a blank text field here where you can type something. But the UI is not really that good. One of the things is it doesn't really have, as you saw here, it doesn't have a, you know, something like a line. So we can remove that with a styling parameter. Give it a decoration. I guess it's text view. Input decoration collapse. So here it needs to specify a hint text that would be displayed over. That would be like type your message or something. Type your message. Let's change it up like that. So now the line is the text on the bottom, the text is removed. And then there's also this thing you can add that is the send button, right? The send button enters this text. coding is done using the row, and that you can align things to the words by using the column. Basically, if you try, I guess, this system, it's really that simple. So you could wrap this inside of the row. You might have this row when you try to add a text field and something else. So that something else would be an icon. So what I'm trying to do in this YouTube text field icon button, Flutter also provided a large pre-made widget or chart that gives you functionality. So you don't have to do everything formally, you don't have to set a text field icon button or chart. There were different buttons around it. You can find them on the Rasu library page. So I'm going to add the icon button. The icon would be an icon widget, and the data would be icons .send. And then it needs an action. So it gives you give it the property of address would be simply a function. I'm so sorry. If I haven't introduced you to the programming language before, it is Dart. It's really closely related to Java, so you don't have any problems doing with it. If you have any OOP experience, object-oriented experience, so it's really common. So now you'd have this here, nothing is displaying. That's because a text, a row doesn't give a width to its chart. You need to explicitly tell that this widget would take any amount of space. So you can either use expanded or flexible. So if I can now, and then there we go. So now you have this nice routine. You can add a padding to it. Padding is, you know, pushing the contents or margins above, below, left, right. You can add those. Add padding. Enough, so we can use this in a little more. The next thing would be building the actual chat messages. So when you type a message, what is that widget that's going to be displayed? So we'll do that in a separate thing. So I think we need a stateful widget now. I'll tell you more about it right now. Let's go ahead and declare something called message, chat message. So again, let's start with a stateless and then we move to stateful. So chat message. And then it's simply going to be, you know, there is a circular avatar of the name, and then there's your name, user name, and then it's going to be the actual text that will be displayed. So now you could use this circular avatar. So the alignment is going to be breakdown. This is for you. In order to align horizontally, use a row, and then for the name and the message, we could use a column. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's start with the row. Children, this is the context inside the row. So let's try to call it and let's see what happens. Actually, a self-serving avatar for this specific purpose. So you can have, like, suppose I have a username here. You don't really do this just for a showcase. Let's just statically type it, and then my name would be the username. So what this is going to be is the child of it is going to be a text that displays the edge or the name, the first initial. So username. So we find it here, and then we need to add the messages. So to do that, it would give me, I guess, a column. Inside a column will include the two texts. So we have two texts. So the first one would be the username. And then the second thing would be the message. That would be, when we initialize a chat message, it would actually require the message, right? So we need to ask a message before this widget was called. So let's call a parameter for message, actually. So and we can view the constructor. So now, whenever we try to create an instance of a chat message, it would require a message. This message. So this curly braces are more, you know, optional parameters as opposed to a hit at all required composition of the program. So this is optional parameters. So now we could something about Flutter text to track empty weight. Error level. So one way, a handy way to do it is also concatenation data one. String code to dollar sign again, whatever name was the so now I could refresh it inside the string, whatever. So now I'm displaying it. If it's not nutty, please crush it. This is a safe way to do this. So now, chat message will require. Okay, now all the UIs are here, there, and stuff. So what we need to do is roach alignment allowed. How is the UI aligned horizontally and vertically? So if it's a row, I told you it's a horizontal, so the main axis is the horizontal. The cross axis will be the vertical. So what we need to do right now is change the cross axis alignment, which is by default, right? Cross axis. Start. And then the text is kind of skewed, so kind of make this the same thing on this cross axis. Now it's all here, but we need some spacing between the avatars and the text, right? So we can add either a padding or a margin. So if you want a margin, for example, you wrap it inside a container. So what we do is we wrap it inside a container, agent it on, and I get to work. We need some. Give it a little bit of 6 or something. We have like that. And then the whole thing, it needs a margin because we're going to lay out some other opportunities that we can do. I guess vertical, so vertical, horizontal, and symmetric. Now, when it's actually laid out, it will have this horizontal, maybe. So you can have all your team files here. You could be here as a team data. So you can have accent color, primary color. So that you could reference it from here, the different styles, whenever you're using any part of your UI. So team of context, we like text. Text team. Something else to the team, so say apply punctuation as kind of becomes cool. Okay. So now we're good with the UI, and then what we need to do is, you know, connect the things we did, and then actually make it send when we give it the functionality we need, right? So the first thing we need is, instead of having this guy, right? We want, there is some kind of a list of objects, and then on the bottom, which would be the text input. So as I said, two things vertically, it would be a column. So I just put on a column. Sure. The bottom would be, okay. The bottom would be a building text field, so, and the top would be a list view. So you can go like this. You have the default constructor and also dot view that I got. What's the difference between this builder and the second one will be different from the first one we want. If you want it like that, you could use a build one. So in this you have access to item builder. The item builder requires a function that will take in a build context. We don't really need the build context, so we can make underscore build order. But we do need an index. The index meaning this to that, getting your index from currently building at the build context. So we kind of take this, and then we should return a widget here. Okay. The widget would be the chat app. Yeah, we can have a list of this chat. We're just declaring chat message that would be stored like type card as well as use number. So then so the first one would be the first one from the chat, and then as it goes on. So index here, I can access the mark. And by the way, we also need to give it the item count. It will be the chat messages names. So whatever we try to put on the chat messages widgets, it would be displayed as a list module. And then as a remote text view module. So let's do that. Same thing could be like column like list is an aspect, but to give it an infinite for list two. I mean, after sessions are long. So, you know, it's so bad. And, you know, either flexible or we can't run on space and diesel. So now it will take the upper part. Maybe have a divider between them here and then. Predefined that. So you'll have a divider something like this here. Okay, it's a function output. And then now, as we type a message, let me have a try. Let's create a new chat message and actually populate the list. So it could be this one here. So, type paragon pala, display the maragon. So we need to create instances of this around our chat. There's no Thank you. what goes wrong. When you declare something here, stateless random. It can't have a default undetermined. In order to track changes, UI and inside Addis message which is up, but also updating that we need it to have and then maintaining state. That's why we use the state for the job. So you can easily say after turn the state. If you create a state separate from state and then you don't have to deal much about this. You still have this build method. That's what it does. But now you can actually update the UI. So now you can submit, but nothing happens for you. That's because in order to modify the UI, some changes happen. We need to call the set state in the section. So inside the set state, you can go set state and then you have inside this function, you call whatever that makes a change to the UI. It's not supposed to be like that, we improve it. Another thing, let's think of yourself sending model control. Currently, I have on text, send model control. So we need to control whatever is on the text. For that, we have the text meaning control. And every UI has every widget has its own init method, build the method up and then dispose. Init one, then a UI view is correct, yellow state. Zale, you could declare your variables, like something that you will dispose later on. So suppose I wanted to do this. The right actual way to do it is on the init. So, and then don't forget to dispose it. So if you had something like so after the UI actually closes, or even closing the app, this would be called first. So now we need to dispose this. Then remember here where is the text node. As we send it, we call the onSend. It actually passes the message. But here, you can't really reference the message from here. It's a different widget icon. This is a text code. So in order to actually know what is on the text, we can call this, and we need message right here, right? So we give it the controller, the text. This would give us an access to the actual text right now. Now, why is that? Because the controller won't allow us to bind the text field, so we didn't bind the controller. It's not finding the action. Now we can check it out. Oh, now it works. And also, after you send a message, normally you can read that book. You allow text in the book, right? So you clear it out. And then it's up on this again. So, funny thing about this, message is collated and checked. And then order actually has a DML part. So we need to fix that, right? This reaction is reverse analog. So, I'm going to show you like my one. That's need to stop in the second. So, let's go ahead. It's here. And then reverse property, I look through my level. And it will be from the bottom. They're not quite right, but it's okay. Just telling message or messages. In order to do that, it would be instead of just adding more. I'm separating whatever they must have instead of just adding. Instead of just adding insert. Then insert the variable, not on the bottom, it actually changes the size of this update. So you can do that. It's really simple. So in order to add an animation, we need an animation controller. So we are here on the chat message.
You would require an animation.
We need to accept this animation controller. Now what we want to do is control about the layout, how it's actually laid out. So it's actually gives a reference to framework of Bubu Sarago. So we have the sticker provided, but it makes sense. So with Malak, you can also function normally to extend the nominal. But if you want that, just the simple functionality to be on this class, we could use this with. It's a mix set as a concept. So ticker provider on the mix set, it gives you access about the current state of the loop. So we can have this missing this and then it should request the current.
This should work with the
mix. I think I need to change this and close this one because it's not going to be rendered once. Forgot to instantiate the animation. So what you need to do is animation controller explicitly manager on the watch for arguments do the animation. So you need to do that. Okay, now it has this animation. You can make it slow so you can actually see what's happening. This is really slow, but you kind of see the size factor linearly increasing. This is fine. So a couple of things. You might need to dispose this animation to which I'm not sure because cleaning up model you move up. And then I think this is all about the chat app. I wanted to introduce you to Firestore, right? I couldn't read our origins and interview on my brother. So if any of you guys are following me and have questions, then I've got I have time to do so. Go around and get stuff if you're actually doing it. And then thank you about that.
Beni anlama olma.